Good evening, dear YouTube viewers, those who have joined right now here at my channel, Dhaka, the capital city of Bangladesh. Welcome you all. Today is 13th December 2019. Temperature is 23 degrees centigrade. It is falling down and humidity is 54% at night. Now time is 2200 hours. And I am inside my room, and outside is little cold, not much. We are not taking the warm cloth yet. Well, you can see very well, this is a store-bought some plants that I am going to show you. It's not unboxing, because these are all store-bought. So let us start with the one. We would like to start first with the this is sphagnum moss. I bought it because I need this for doing the potting, and I would like to start with the smaller one first. This one is a smaller purchase, but this is a lady sleeper and it has a bud. I don't know the color. This is a lady sleeper and Papia petalium. It's a nice one. Now I have to either pot on this one, or have a choice of potting onto this one. This is little bigger. This will be too big, way too big. This is much more bigger. So my selection first goes to this pot. Well, the potting media will be only charcoal, then some brick chips and some pumice stone. So that's all will be the potting media. So this is the first one, and then let's move to the second one. Second one is here. I hope you will like it. I hope you will like this one. So this is a Phalaenopsis single stick. These are all Taiwan breed, and they were potted in a coconut chips, with a coconut chips. But what I am planning, that they came with this, on this size pot, like this. Now, what I am planning to suit my weather, what I am going to do, I will not disturb the coconut chips that are those are attached with the plant. Only I will just snip out the old roots, and then I give some hydrogen peroxide, keep it dry. After that, those coconut chips are attached, I'll keep them, okay? And then I'll put sphagnum moss around. Now, what is going to happen if I go for making these coconut chips wet, and then the sphagnum moss is going to be more wet. And if I do not want the sphagnum moss to get more wet, then they will remain dry. So if they remain dry or moist, is not a problem. I think so, is not a problem. But if the sphagnum moss is too wet, too heavy, too wet, too water absorbing, then in this season, in my country, it will be little difficult, because the dry cycle time will be longer, and that may cause root rot. That may cause root rot. So I'll try to keep the dry cycle in between watering. I'll try to keep a dry cycle, and the watering time I should keep it within 3, maximum 4 days. Maximum 4 days. So if I want to maintain the watering cycle 3 to 4 days with sphagnum moss, then I must avoid soaking. I must avoid soaking. I just pour water, pouring water, so that the sphagnum moss are moist and can keep it moist. And they will be in the grow space with the LED spectrum light and circulating fan. They will not go outside. So this is the flower. I hope you have liked it. So this is one. I have total four different colors. Let's go for the second one. Second one is here. I'm excited to see the color. Oh my God, this is a white with some pink spot. White, some pink spot. I'm really excited. See the color? So beautiful. These are, I think, all Taiwan breed. These are not Bangkok breed, although they came from Bangkok. But they are not Bangkok breed. This is also having very small. Whatever the coconut chips fall down, let it fall down. I am not going to force it. Let it fall down, and then I'll pot it. This is the second one. Now, the third one. Third one is here. Let's see the color. I hope you like it. Have you seen it? I think you have not seen it yet, but I have seen it. No surprise, just sharing with you. This is the color. This is like cheetah. You see, the tiger cheetah. This is like cheetah, but no ID. I don't know the ID. If you know the ID, if you have this, please let me know. This is also having the same root system, and the coconut chips has fallen down, so it's very hard to decide. Anyway, all will be potted in the same category, same media, and in the same way. And then the last one. Let's see the color. Last one. I'm very lucky to get all these different colors, and these are store-bought Phalaenopsis. I'm so lucky to have these colors. This is a new addition in my collection. I hope you have seen this one already. Still, let's see a closer view. This one is little light, and this is little deep. These two side by side, almost same looking, but this is little deep and this is little light, and the spots are also little different. Anyway, almost similar color, but have got some difference. Almost similar color, but have got some difference. Anyway, so these are the four store-bought Phalaenopsis I have purchased today, and you can see them all together. It's 2, 3, and this is a 1, 4. These are total 4 I have purchased today. I hope you have liked it. And with this, I have purchased another species of Papia pedalium, lady slipper, this one. So these all will be, I'll be potting this all tonight. And I'm sorry, I cannot share with you the potting. But I hope that even I cannot share, you will be able to see after potting when I make the other videos. So with this, here I come to the end of my today's video. Gentlemen, if you have liked my video, please give a thumbs up, and if you have any question, you can ask me, or have some suggestions for me, the comment box is open. You are welcome. You can give any suggestion, and I am always suggestion loving guy, and I like people suggestion. And about Phalaenopsis, I would like to mention, I had some trouble about the water system and understanding the water, and with the guidance of Margaret, I am really grateful to her. Now I understand the water and the moisture system, and now the Phalaenopsis are very interesting plant to me. It was not before. Thank you, Margaret, and thank you very much for joining me, and stay tuned. In my next video, I am going to do the potting of my Grammatopholium, the spectrum leopard, the big one which I have purchased, and that one I am going to report tomorrow. Stay fine. Bye-bye.